नमस्कार, स्वागत है आपका राज्यसभा टीवी में। आपके साथ मैं हूं अभिलाषा पाठक। उपराष्ट्रपति एम वेंकैया नायडू ओडिशा के दौरे पर हैं। उपराष्ट्रपति कटक में ओडिया डेली पेपर दैनिक समाज की शताब्दी समारोह में मुख्य अतिथि के रूप में पहुंचे हुए हैं। आइए सीधा वहां का रुख करते हैं।
संसद श्री भर्तृहरि मेहता जी, डाक विभाग सचिव श्रीयुक्त ए एन नंदा, लोक सेवक मंडल का सभापति श्रीयुक्त दीपक मालवीय महोदय, लोक सेवक मंडल का ट्रस्टी श्रीयुक्त डॉक्टर एस एन सुबाराव, लोक सेवक मंडल का संपादको श्रीयुक्त निरंजन जी, समाजरा परिचालना मंडली कार्यनिर्वाही संपादको श्रीयुक्त भीमसेन जी, समाजरा कार्यकारी मुख्य परिचालको श्रीयुक्त प्रियव्रत महंति महोदय, गणमाध्यमर समस्त प्रतिनिधि मानंकु मो प्रिय भाई भौणी मानंकु संस्थंकु नमस्कार। ರಾಜ್ಯರ ಪ್ರಮುಖ ಖಬರ್ ಕಾಗಜ್ ಸಮಾಜರ ಶತವಾರ್ಷಿಕ ಉತ್ಸವರೇ ಆಜಿ ಮೂ ಜೋಗ ತೆಯ್ದಿವಾರು ಬಹುತ್ ಆನಂದಿತೋ ಆಜಿರ್ ಏ ಶುಭ ಅವಸರ ಪರ ಮೂ ಉತ್ಕಳಮಣಿ ಗೋಪಬಂಧು ದಾಸ್ ಕೋಜಿ ಜಿಬೋನಿ ಪುಸ್ತಕ ಉನ್ಮೋಚನ ಕರೆ ದಿವಾರು ಬಹುತ್ ಆನಂದಿತೋ ಎಹಿ ಮಹತ್ವಪೂರ್ಣ ಅವಸರರೆ ಸಮಾಜ ಪರಿವಾರರ ಸಮಸ್ತ ಸಭ್ಯಂಕು ಶುಭೇಚ್ಛಾ ಜನಾವತಿ ಬ್ರದರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಐ ಕಾಂಟ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ ಟು ಯು ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್ ಮದರ್ ಟಂಗ್ ದ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಒಡಿಯಾ ಐ ಆಮ್ ವೆರಿ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ಟು ಬಿ ಅಡ್ಮಿಸ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ ಟುಡೇ ದಿಸ್ ಈವ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ ಸ್ಟೇಡಿಯಂ in a beautiful atmosphere with all you at the centennial celebrations of the Samaja, the premier Odia Daily. At the outset, let me extend my heartiest congratulations to the Samaja family on this momentous occasion. Completion of 100 years is a significant milestone in the journey of an organization. It's a testimony to your commitment to journalistic excellence, your dedication to objective reporting, and above all, the popularity you enjoy among the people of Odisha. I am told that the Samaja took birth in 1919 as a weekly newspaper from the Shatabdi in Puri district with the vision of informing, educating and empowering the people of Odisha and facilitating the development of the state and the nation. I am glad to note that the Samaja has remained the nerve center of journalism, intellectual pursuit and social service in Odisha since its inception a century ago. I believe that Samaja is also considered to be the gold standard of India, Odia language, and is a true delight to the literati of the state, so much so that elders of Odisha encourage their children to read the Samaja to perfect Odia language. I also applaud the Samaja for transcending its journalistic mandate and engaging in the service of the poor and oppressed. I am happy to know that a major portion of its revenue is used for the welfare of the people hit by calamities. It is indeed an example worth emulating for all across the country. Journalism, politics, medicine, education once upon a time was considered as a mission. Of late, some people started giving it some omission, taking some remission, and also adding to commission. That is not being followed by Samaja. That is the speciality of this newspaper. That's why I compliment them and congratulate them on this historic occasion of completing 100 years. It's a mission to serve the people, to educate the people, to highlight what is happening in the society, to reflect the surroundings of the state and the people at large. That is the duty of a newspaper. I'm very happy that this newspaper has been conducting itself in such a dignified manner, in an objective manner. The illustrious founder of the Samaja, Utkalamani Pandit Gopabandhu Das, was a great teacher, a Renaissance poet, a prolific writer, and a seasoned journalist, a selfless social worker, an erudite legislator, a frontline freedom fighter, and of course, a great proponent of Gandhian ideologies and moral values. Gandhiji was relevant yesterday, is relevant today, will be relevant tomorrow, because Gandhiji's teachings are eternal. He was also, Utkalamani Pandit Gopabandhu Das was a dedicated educationist. He constantly spoke of the need for all citizens to fulfill their fundamental duties. I am glad to note that he was also a firm believer in the ancient Indian ideals of Vasudeva Kutumbakam and dedicated his life to the service of his countrymen. My dear young friends, the basic philosophy of India is Vasudeva Kutumbakam. The entire world is one family. Sarve jana sukhino bhavantu. Share and care is the core of Indian philosophy. I am very happy that led by Sri Subbaraoji, more than 1,000 youngsters from across the country have all assembled here to participate in a rachanatmak, in Gandhi's words, in a constructive activity, to think constructively, do something constructively. It's a very noble mission that has been taken up, correcting all the youngsters across the country and motivating them to go for constructive work. That is what is required today. I am also delighted to release the book on Utkalamani Gopabandhu Das, written by Dr. Subhash Chandra Misra today. I hope that this book will take the life and story of the great icon to the younger generations and serve as an inspiration. I appreciate the Samaja for building a towering edifice of understanding journalism on the strong foundations of morals, values, ethics laid by its visionary founder. My dear sisters and brothers, the press in India has a long and illustrious history ever since the first newspaper, Bengal Gazette, was published by James Augustus Hickey in 1780. The press played a pivotal role in inspiring people and voicing their aspirations when the struggle to gain independence from the British began gathering momentum. It acted as a great unifier, bringing the people from different walks of life and different backgrounds together to fight for the noble cause of freedom. The press remained undaunted by the ironical restrictions imposed by the Britishers at the time. The same resolute spirit continues to be the hallmark of the Indian media ever since independence. Bearing a temporary deviation during the dark times of emergency, the media has been trying to be always objective. Today, India's vibrant media landscape is dotted with thousands of journals and newspapers, hundreds of TV channels, and scores of radio stations. Of course, you also have social media, which has become one of the main drivers of information in the digital age. But please take note, information with confirmation is more than an ammunition. You must have information with confirmation. Merely just passing on information without confirmation, without verification, will cause havoc. That is what is happening at times because of social media. Social media is doing something good positively, but also adding something negative also. We are all watching what is happening. My dear sisters and brothers, democracy is a government of the people, for the people, and by the people. It gives equal chance to all citizens to participate and play a significant role in the political process and guarantees certain inalienable rights and freedoms to the people. A democratic system will succeed only if there is an extensive participation of its citizens in governance process. People should also participate, not only in governance, they should also participate in development programs. Without people's participation, nothing will succeed, because unfortunately over the years, some sort of psychology has been developed among the people, by particularly by people who are at the helm of affairs, saying that everything will be done by the government. You don't worry. Aap chinta mat karo. Sab kaam sarkar karega. Hum bekar baithe to chirega. Aisa nahi chirega. You can't be ideal. You have to participate in the governance. Not only simply putting a vote at 5 years, but also closely monitoring and participating in the governmental programs which are development-oriented, which are welfare-oriented. That is the need of the ABBA. Peace, people's participation can be encouraged by the media, can be motivated by the media. this participation will be meaningful, one, if only citizens are well informed and educated. Access to information is essential for a democratic society because it ensures that citizens make responsible, informed choices rather than act out of ignorance or misinformation. Thus, reliable source of information from an important constant of a democratic society. This is where the role and importance of media lies. As I was telling you, we have now more than 1,000 channels. How many channels? Nobody knows. Every day, like our population of India, channels population also is growing. It's good, but at the same time, simply because of competition, because of temptation for TRP, the media should not go for sensationalization. Sensationalization means without sense. Without sense is sensationalization. There has to be sense in what you propagate. Simply because you want to score over others, making news, breaking news, good news, bad news, it's khud unka news bhi chala rahe aajkal. Ye paddhati achha nahi hai. The information must have confirmation, and it must be educative, it must be constructive, and it must motivate the people, which will do something good to the common cause of the people of India. That is the responsibility of the media. And electronic media should introspect seriously and see to it that they are adhere to those standards. And print media also must do the same thing. This is my advice to all the media. Breaking news, headlines, making headline. But let us be very clear that headline should not be a deadline to us. We must carry our own line. We must only take note of that line, that's all. Their headline cannot be a deadline to us. But at the same time, if the headline is really meaningful, conveys something good, that will really change the line if somebody is going in a wrong path. My dear friends, brothers and sisters, the media in a democracy has a very important role to play. But some instances here and there of fake news, paid news, they're all very disturbing. That might have been indulged in by few people, but the few people are bringing bad name to the journalistic community. So I would like to caution everybody to see that we live by our value systems, our ethics, and then carry on our professions without fear or favor. Media must inform, educate, and enlighten people. It has a critical role to play in the formation of public opinion. It must endure citizens and help in ensuring a greater transparency and accountability in the governance system. It must amplify the voice of citizens and communicate their opinions to the lawmakers. Media also plays a crucial role in ensuring good governance in a democracy. Support of media may yield results in governance activities, particularly those related to decentralization, anti-corruption, and citizen participation in the policy process. Free and fair elections conducted through transparent process require a media sector which gives candidates equal access and reports the relevant issues in a timely, objective manner. People should be educated about the issues, about the manifesto of the parties, about the performance of the candidates. And I suggest that people should select and elect leaders with who have got character, caliber, capacity and conduct. These four C's are very important. Character, caliber, capacity and conduct. Unfortunately, some people are trying to short circuit it by other four C's. The first four C's are character, caliber, capacity and conduct. The other four C's are caste, community, cash and criminality. We should be careful about this replacement. And the media plays an important role in educating the people, in giving about the background as a member of parliament or legislative assembly or members of a political party, how they have conducted earlier, how they have performed in the legislature, how they are performing in parliament, what has then been their contribution, how many times he was there in the house, how many times he went to the well of the house. There is a saying, if you are not well on the facts, go to the well of the house. This is what our seniors have said. So we have to be careful. The people, parliament, legislature, municipality are there to see that people's views are represented and good legislations are made. So one has to be very objective, constructive, not destructive or obstructive. This has to be taken note. And such conduct of the people's representatives should be highlighted by the media without any bias. This is what is required for proper functioning of the legislatures and strengthening of the democracy. Media must also expose the loopholes in the democratic system, which ultimately helps the government in filling the vacuum and gaps, making the system more accountable, responsive and citizen-friendly. A democracy without media is akin to a vehicle without any wheels. A free and fair media is not just a part of healthy democracy, but also is an indispensable prerequisite. Media has been considered the fourth pillar of our democratic system, a pillar that supports, nurtures, nourishes the democracy and helps in course correction as and when necessary. It will always help the people in power to correct themselves if they get proper feedback, whether their programs are reaching the people or not, whether they are being implemented properly or not. That feedback, if the media gives, then the government of the day, if their intentions are good, they can take course correction. This is where the importance of the media and the constructive role of media is there. Although freedom of the press has not been overtly recognized as a fundamental right in our constitution, a perusal of the extensive debates of the Constituent Assembly makes it abundantly clear that there was wide-ranging consensus about considering media freedom as an extension of fundamental freedom of expression. After that, several decisions of the Supreme Court gave legitimacy to this recognition. Mahatma Gandhi once said that, I quote, "Freedom of the press is precious privilege no country can forego." My dear sisters and brothers, media is a national resource that the journalists use in public interest. Mahatma Gandhi once said that it is the duty of journalists to realize the public opinion of the country and give it a vocal expression boldly. In view of the tremendous responsibility it holds, media must remain honest, truthful, and act with great restraint, responsibility, placing the welfare of the common man and the progress of the nation at the center of all its activities. Mahatma Gandhi also said that the objective of journalism should only be social service. Journalism is a mission, as I said earlier. TRPs, circulation figures, and bottom lines through important must not be dictate your path. Media must shun tendency to sensationalize and must take care to stick to the facts dispassionately and steadfastly and must diligently desist from making news and views. Don't mix news and views. There is a tendency among certain sections of the media across the country. They try to combine the news with views. Views has to be confined to editorial page or separate articles. News, in its real sense, should be conveyed to the people. That should be the line. It must also get rid of the established prejudices and give voice to the expectations of the youth, women, farmers, and entrepreneurs. Media must act as a moral compass and the conscious of the society and must aggressively campaign to end all social evils, untouchability, social discrimination, gender discrimination, urban-rural divide. These are the areas media should always focus and highlight and guide the society and educate the new generation. It's really a shame, even after 72 years of independence, there are still here and there we hear some cases of social discrimination and some cases of gender discrimination. Women, they constitute 50% of the population. They should be given their due. Women, some people say, sir, wo to unko maalu nahi kaisa vyavhar karna, kaisa sambhalna unko maalu nahi. Aapko maalu hai kya shuru mein? Aapne bhi seekha, wo bhi seekhenge. Some people, they used to tell me, sir, you are advocating women's empowerment, giving them equal opportunity, but they will not be able to do it. See what is happening in Panchayat Raj bodies. I said, what is happening? Those people told me, sir, see Panchayat Raj bodies in certain states. It is not Sarpanch, but Sarpanch Pati is sitting there in the chair. So I heard them patiently and I told them, Babu, don't worry. Shuru mein aisi hoga. It will be like that in the beginning. After some time, you will see what will happen to the Gati of the Pati. You will come to know of it in the coming days. Gati means fate. Pati means husband. So unless you give an opportunity, how do you know? And they are 50% of the population. It has been our tradition since ages. Maitreyi, Gargayi, they used to come in open. Even those days, Vedas and Upanishads, they also have given equal importance. Even our goddesses, if you believe in Purana, Saraswati, education, Parvati, defense, Lakshmi, finance, That was the importance given even in our Puranas also. So now even our rivers, Godavari, Mahanadi, Narmada, Tapati, Mahendra Tanaya, Krishna, Kaveri, Saraswati, Yamuna, all the names are named after women. That is the tradition and culture of this great country. Let us follow the tradition and encourage women and give them due pace, and they will also show their capacity and caliber. And also, my dear friends, in the present day situation, what is required is that we must take the development to the people. जो अंतिम पंक्ति में बैठे उनका उत्थान पहले होना चाहिए. महात्मा गांधी ने कहा, दीनदयाल उपाध्याय ने कहा, डॉक्टर अंबेडकर ने कहा, जो अंतिम पंक्ति में बैठे उनका उत्थान, जो अंतिम पंक्ति में ये स्टेडियम में बैठे उनका उत्थान नहीं है, समाज में जो द पीपल आर देयर इन द लास्ट लाइन इन द क्यू, दे शुड बी टेकन केयर. द सप्रेस द डिप्रेस द अप्रेस द पीपल, दे हैव टू बी टेकन केयर. एवरीबडी इन द सोसाइटी मस्ट फील that is also part of the developmental story of Odisha, developmental story of India. That feeling has to be created. For that, government must reach them, and media should reach it, people's expectation to the government. That is what is need to be done. It's a two-way traffic. And secondly, the Honorable Prime Minister gave a three-line mantra. He said reform, perform, and transform. Transformation of the nation, that is what is required. 72 years after independence, still 20% illiterates, 18 to 20% below poverty line, some cases of social discrimination. These are the challenges before the society, the new generation, the younger generation, and the country political system must accept these challenges, focus more on that. The programs that are given by the government, either by Naveen Babu's government or Narendra Bhai Modi's government, if the program is good, that should be taken to the masses, and we must consider it as a people's movement. Swachh Bharat, Clean India. Swachh Bharat is for your body, not for Modi. You have to understand that. Swachh Bharat or yoga is for your body, not for Modi. You have to understand that. And secondly, Beti Bachao, Beti Padao. For drop crop or tree plantation or Fit India program, these are all programs that has to become and converted into a people's movement. Inko ek janandolan ka roop dena chahiye. This where this constructive thinking and Gandhian philosophy is very relevant. Gandhiji told everybody to get involved in constructive activity. Rachanatmak karyakram ka naam diya hoga. So this is where the youth of the country, they should be motivated. This should be our program. Single plastic and no use of single plastic. And then following civic rules and regulations, cleanliness, as I told you, and also having good lifestyle, eating good food. Nowadays, lifestyle changes are happening very fast. We are trying to follow Western countries. That may have suited them there, but in our country, we have our own lifestyle. Lifestyle changes are instrumental in increasing the non-communicable diseases. This is what the report says. We have to be careful about diabetic, cancer, obesity. Many of the problems are coming because of lifestyle changes. No activity at all. That's why PM said Fit India. Fit India is for our sake, for our body. And secondly, food habits also. We are slowly trying to follow Western food habits. And people say, sir, instant food, sir. Instant food means constant disease. You have to understand this. If the food is instant, it will be constant to have disease for you. The food has to be cooked properly according to season. In India, we have so many varieties of food quality across the country. We must, youngsters, we must get back to our Indian system. Our local food here in Odia or across the country, there are so many varieties. Wonderful choices are available to you. So these are all fundamental things, elementary things, but they're all important. Discipline in life, dedication in life, and also following, respecting elders, respecting the teacher, and also respecting the mother tongue also is equally important. Mother tongue is very important because it has come from mother's womb, and bhasha aur bhavana ek saath chalta hai. Mother tongue is like your eyesight. Mother tongue, matru bhasha, is like your eyesight, and the other language is like your spectacles. If you have eyesight, the spectacles will give you good sight. If you don't have eyesight, even wearing Ray-Ban glasses is not going to improve. So you have to, first of all, be perfect in Odia. Learn your mother tongue, promote your mother tongue, practice your mother tongue, and learn other languages also. Learning as many languages as possible. Learning Hindi, learning English, learning Bengali, learning Telugu, Tamil, Kannada, Malayali, Marathi, Punjabi, Assami, or even French or Chinese, no problem. First, promote your mother tongue and then practice other things. That is what is required. That's why I stress that all the government schools and educational institutions must promote mother tongue up to primary level. This is very much necessary. That's where I support vernacular dailies, Samaja, the newspapers that are run in state languages. I don't call them as regional languages. They are the real national languages. And these papers should be encouraged. That's why I came all the way to participate in this function of 100-year celebration of this noble newspaper, which is doing a good job because it is feeding the people of Odisha with the news in their own mother tongue. Such things should be encouraged. The media must be a vehicle for change in status quo. It must highlight the positive stories and best practices so that they inspire positive changes and can be replicated everywhere. Media must play a constructive role in solving burning problems of our time, from poverty to disease to climate change. They would have already witnessed the stellar role played by Indian media in making the Swachh Bharat movement a success. My dear brothers and sisters, Prime Minister declared India is open defecation free. And a lot of credit for these achievements goes to the media, because media have given wide coverage to the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. They should continue to do it, because it's not one day issue. It's not a one day issue. Swachh Bharat has to be a continuous process. Like you clean your body, you clean your teeth every day. You can't say I will do it on October 2nd only and do it next October 2nd, brushing the teeth and all. It has to be done on daily basis. You have to wash your body on daily basis. Same thing is Swachh Bharat also. It must now take up more such missions on national interest, such as Fit India, and turn them into people's movement. Media must also lend a helping hand in protecting, preserving, promoting India's rich cultural heritage and languages. Love and live with the nature. Nature, culture, together for better future. That should be the motto. Protect the nature. Protect the rivers. Protect the trees. Protect the animals. That will protect you also. So nature, culture, together for a better future, that should be the way forward for all of us. We are living in an area of rapidly preferring social media, byproduct of which is fake news. The pervasive menace of fake news now threatens to destroy the credibility of media. We have to be very careful about it. Under such circumstances, we must be prepared to effectively tackle and disapprove fake news by taking control of the narrative. We must devise creative solutions to contain fake news. You must tackle paid news and the same deal too. My dear sisters and brothers, though we live in an era of digital and electronic media, print media continues to be important. It will create an imprint in your mind, especially in India. Estimates say that the print media is going up when compared with the previous this thing. That's a very positive thing. I hope that more and more vernacular newspapers, that is national newspapers, would come up in India, promoting the languages and spreading the prosperity of our rural people. Not only the so-called regional newspapers reflect local aspirations, you also much closer to the public. You can really transform the rural landscape of India through your prudent, prompt and truthful reporting. I urge you to take positive stories from the local community to larger audience. My dear friends, youngsters, on this occasion of this 100 years of celebration, while highlighting the achievements and good work done by this great newspaper, I call upon the entire media across the country to do some soul searching, see to it whether they are all running their newspapers according to the objectives enshrined, and see to it that the common good of the people, the public interest of the people, that is given foremost importance, and the social maladies and the evils, they are taken care by taking action against the people and also educating the younger generation for a better future of the country. Lastly, India has a bright future. The World Bank, the World Economic Forum, the International Monetary Fund, the Asian Development Bank, all are saying if India moves with the speed and center and state work together, India can become the third largest economy in the world. And nobody can stop us. For that, All of us have to join together. We are all stakeholders. We must be constructive in our approach. We must be positive in our approach. We must be positive in our outlook. Political parties will be there. Elections will be there. Once it is over, we must all join together to strengthen the value system, to see to it that the society moves in a positive direction and a constructive manner. Once again, I would like to compliment the management of this great newspaper and also the journalists who are working in that newspaper, who are mainly responsible for getting this good name, and also the other workers who are all working in that organization. I convey my best wishes to all of them, and I would like to convey to all of you my Vijayadashami greetings to all of you. Namaskar, Jai Hind.